استغيث به، أن أنادي بابا أو ماما أو أوباما في هذا الضيق وفي هذا الكرب. لا أقول هيل يا برادر، هيل ماي بابا أو ماي داد أو هيل ماما أو أوباما، وإنما على قلب رجل واحد الطالح والصالح والعاصي والمؤمن حتى الملحد، الجميع يقولون يا الله يا الله يا الله.
So let us take the example of the world that we live in nowadays. Imagine that you are on a ship in a very stormy weather on the midst of an ocean that's very rough. And the Shaykh Hafidhullah describes it as, imagine it's like a feather in a very in a large storm. And everyone's holding their heart, what's going to happen in this storm? Are we going to live through it? Are we going to make it? Where is the exit? How are we going to be safe? And so who do you call on as a person? Do you call on your mother, your father, mama, baba, or Obama, a president? Or as any person would do out in the sea, he would call upon the natural instinct. The instinct is calling upon your Lord, your Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لأن الفطرة بطبيعتها التي كانت غافلة أو ناهبة في حركة الحياة تستيقظ عن الضيق وتدرك الصنعة اللجوء إلى الصانع، ويدرك المخلوق اللجوء إلى الخالق حيث لا صانع ولا خالق إلا الله.
And this is because your natural disposition, what we call your inner instinct, which you were born with, when it is exposed to a turbulent environment or let's say put under stress or pressure, it comes out. And this is where you find that people turn to their creator or turn to a higher being, and surely that natural instinct or natural disposition, which is the fitrah, this is when it comes out and starts stirring emotion, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
كفرك بجميع الآلهة الباطلة، وعند الضيق تستشعر أن القادر على إنقاذك وعلى إغاثتك هو خالقك الذي لا يغفل ولا ينام.
So under that pressure, under that stress, that natural instinct comes out, and one comes to realize or to reject all other avenues of help, all other avenues of aid apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that natural instinct comes out and makes you remember and realize that even though you had been heedless or sleeping on this path before, but it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ever living, the one who does not sleep, who is there watching your state.
يتعرض الإنسان لحادث أعطاكم الله من كل داء، فكسرت يده أو رجله أو نزل الدم من بدنه، ساعة يشعر بهذا الكرب ينادي من قلبه يا الله يا الله يا الله، ولا يقول يا ابني ولا يا بابا ولا يا ماما.
Imagine that you were in a horrific accident. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of you safe. Your initial state or your outburst at that moment is you don't call upon your mother or your father. You call upon the one who is truly able to help you, your creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so that emotion is driven out of you because it is inbuilt within every one of us.
وَأَشَدُّ أَنْوَاعِ الْكُرُوبِ الَّتِي سَتَحِلُّ بِكَ كَرْبٌ بِيَدِ سِوَاكَ لا تدري متى يغشاك، وهو كرب قادم لا محالة لا ينجو منه أحد، كرب سكرات الموت.
And there is a calamity which every one of us will go through. No one can escape. The greatest of calamities, the calamity that is feared or is found to be difficult by everyone, and that is the moment of death.
في كل هموم الدنيا وكروب الدنيا استشعرت أن الذكر والنداء واللجوء لا يكون إلا لله، فكيف بك وأنت قادم على الله؟
Saying all these examples, be it at sea, be it an accident happens to you, you lose a loved one and what have you, you realize that there is nothing that you can turn to or no one to turn to except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then how about this at the moment of death, at the moment where really no one else can help you, who should you turn to?
بَرَدَتْ قَدَمَاكَ
When your feet become cold,
وَجَمَدَتْ رِجْلَاكَ تَقَلَّصَتْ حَدَقَتَاكَ سَالَتْ دَمْعُ مِنْ عَيْنَيْكَ
You become frozen, your limbs are not mobile, and the tear may have come down upon your face, realizing your final moments and what you are in.
وَالْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِالسَّاقِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسَاقِ سَعِدْهَا تَسْتَشْعِرْ الأحوال الخمس إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون فتقول من قلبك ليس لي إلا أنت يا أرحم الراحمين.
And so if that journey continues, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, the day in which the ankles hit the ankles, the feet overcrowding, you come to realize that on this journey, as you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you remember the meaning that says, to Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.
وَلَوْ أَلْهَمَكَ اللَّهُ قَبْلَ خُرُوجِ رُوحِكَ قَبْلَ أَنْ تَبْلُغَ الرُّوحُ الْحُقُومَ وَاسْتَشْعَرْتَ أَنُّ مَلِكَ لَا يَرْحَمُكَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ اسْتَكْثَرْتَ ذُنُوبَكَ وَطَلَبْتَ وَلَجَأْتَ وَطَمِعْتَ فِي رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي هَذَا الْمَوْقِفِ يعني خائف من ذنوبك وتطمع في رحمة الله إلا أمنك الله وغفر لك.
And glad tidings be to the person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them, inspires them to at the moment of death for them to realize that really there is no hope for them except the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at that moment they start, and just before that moment they start asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they start regretting for their sins and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them.
وهنا نضع أرجلنا على سلم أول خطوات الطريق.
And now we are placing our feet at the beginning of this journey.
ما هو الطريق العلمي والعملي الذي يعرفني على ربي سبحانه وتعالى حتى يكون معي لأكون معه في وقت الرخاء ليكون معي وقت الشدة ليكون معي لما أتعرض لحادث في البر أو في البحر أو على فراش الموت كيف أكون في معية الله ليكون معي في هذا الطريق.
So the question no doubt is how can I be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can I in those situations, how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remember me, be a calamity in your life, out sea, as we mentioned, in an accident, at a moment of death, on a day of judgment, how can you, what is the practical and what is the path of knowledge and practice that you can seek so that you can be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the times of ease, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be with you at the times of these calamities and hardship. In the hadith, that if you get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, get closer to Allah at the time of ease, when you have health, when you have wealth, when everything is fine with you, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you at the time of your hardship.
هذه الدروس المتوالية إن شاء الله تبارك وتعالى حسب قدر الأولى تبارك وتعالى موجهة إلى شباب الجالية الإسلامية الإسرائيلية وإلى كل شباب المهجرين بل هي زاد تصلح لكل شباب الأمة إن شاء الله تبارك وتعالى.
So the intention of these lessons is to